large, you just want to slot your filter over. Mine came with a Hydra Shield, lovely.
To the folks, Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door, ready to make an entrance, so back on up.
Welcome back to the channel. This week on Modify Weekly, we are fitting an Injen cold air intake to the EP3 Type R. Proven statistically, the Injen gives you the most horsepower gains compared to the Tagiwa or AEM or any of them other big known brands. So that's what I went for. First things first, with your air box, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Phillips head screws you've got to undo. I was going to first start off by undoing every screw, but it turns out that they're all rusted.
Just let it rust.
Seized on.
Absolutely disgusting.
Twisted and rounded out.
Shut up, mate.
Now we're going to start on the 10mm bolts everywhere, and then hopefully just get the whole box out, which will be a result. Well, to get to your intake connection from the airbox, you're going to need to get your IVTEC cover off. Also, apologies that we're talking so quiet and stuff. It's because it's late and we've already had complaints about working on cars and making videos, so it's all good. Okay, so up next, you want to remove your breather from the rocker cover, and I don't really know what this little hose here does, but you've got to remove that as well.
Basic knowledge.
Remove it from this end. You're going to want to loosen off your Jubilee clips. Oh yeah, also you want to make sure your air temperature sensor is out the way, because you don't want that getting damaged, otherwise you'll have fault codes showing up. Right, come on, just loosen them up nice.
Nice and loose.
So we've disconnected our main hose from the box, so we should just be able to... God, mate, this thing is ginormous. Big old air box.
It's fucking giant, mate.
So now we just want to slide the main tube off, and there we go. That's the old airbox out.
Another 10mm there, which gets your old pipe that connects to the back of the airbox out. So we have found an entrance point through that hole. Basically, what you have to do is you have to come round, jack your car up, and basically take off your arch liner, and there's a hole there where it slides through and then up. It sits in there. Take that bolt off and it sits up in there.
So now we've got our route through, which was a lot easier than I actually thought it would be. You want to get your silicone elbow, sling it right on your throttle body, something like that. That'll do for now.
So I'm going to feed it up from the bottom into Ollie. Wait. That on?
Yeah, that's in.
Yep, we're in. Don't go tightening stuff down, leave it all with slack until you've got it all positioned up and mounted up. Just so you know you've got it in the right positions.
So now we're down here in the wheel arch. We've got this, whatever it is, mounting bracket going onto this 10mm bolt up here, and that'll secure it into position.
So we've got two silicone hoses, one that replaces that one that goes on that vacuum line, and the other one is for the breather pipe to the rocker cover. So they go from those two slots in there to over there.
So we've just pulled our old air temperature sensor plug out of that little slot there. Now we're going to slot that into... We should have done this earlier, but we're modifying weekly, mate. We do what we want. Oh, God. And well, easy.
Goes in there.
So when you're down in your wheel arch, you just want to slot your filter over. Mine came with a Hydra shield, lovely. And yeah, then just do the Jubilee clip up. We've got it, the bracket all mounted and tightened up. Solid, it's not going nowhere. And yeah, it's nearly there.
So we have got the rocker cover breather pipe on and in and tightened. The vacuum line in and tightened, even though it's a bit big, but you won't cut it back. We've got all the pipes down here tightened.
Then down here we've got the filter on and tightened up. Got the bracket on and it just goes through that lovely hole there. Nice, isn't it? To get the maximum air through to your wheel arch, you're going to want to come and remove this fog light blank. There's little red tabs all around it that you literally just cut with a blade. One more, and there she goes.
So then you can come put basically everything back together, i.e. your battery, your terminals, and your wheel arch liner. Does need to be cut out down there to make sure it goes around the surrounding and you can still get the bolts back in.
So now we've got our wheel arch liner fully built back up, and we've got our little grooves cut out for our Injen where it slots right through. And yeah, in the engine bay, the battery's back in. You can barely tell that there is a mad cold air intake in there. Frees up so much space as well. Jeez. And that, everyone, is how you feel. Injen Kai, it's your EP3 Type R. It's a little bit of a pain in the arse job at first, but literally, once you remove your wheel and your arch liner, it all makes sense where the roots and everything goes. It's really, really easy. It frees up so much room, and hopefully we get some good gains from it. It sounds mad. So yeah, that's all from us today. Tune in next week for another video.
Hello everyone. We're out. This week on Modify Weekly, we are painting my disgusting old peeling rocker cover in matte black.